That is the math soup. Okay, I welcome you all to our today's second maths lecture, maths 1 lecture. From today onwards, we are going to start with our actual syllabus of your 9th standard. I hope that whatever you have learned in the previous week, that really build your basic concepts. And it will really help you further to understand the concepts very much clearly. Okay, so I myself, Saili Sriram Gore, and I am from City of Los Angeles Principal English Secondary School, Mahim West. So today we are going to start with our first chapter. Okay. And if you have gone through the textbook, I hope that this is a maths lecture. So you are with your textbook and your notebook. We are going to study this chapter in detail because every new thing, whatever you are learning, it should be in depth so that it will not create any difficulty in your future. So whatever you are studying, you just note down in your books, and we are going to take each topics in detail so that whatever you are learning in 9th standard, it will be a very much clear concept for you, and it will really helpful for your further standard. Okay, so let us begin. That is the first chapter, sets. If you're having the textbook, it is on page number 1. Okay. So students, till last year, that is 8th standard, you were having only one textbook, that is the mathematics. Okay. So from this year, that is in 9th standard as well as in the 10th standard, you will be having two different textbooks, one for the maths 1 and one for the maths 2. Okay, two different textbooks, and whatever the concepts are there, they are totally different. Only what you have learned in the 8th standard, they were combined in one book, like algebraic expressions, then geometrical figures, constructions, statistics, everything was combined in a single book. Okay, so from this year onwards, it will be totally different in two different separate textbooks. Whatever we are going to learn in mathematics part 1, it is algebraic expression, then statistics and all. And the part 2, that is the mathematics part 2, you will be learning about the construction, triangle, circle and all that. Okay, so here it will really help you to distinguish between the algebra and the geometry. Okay, it will really help you to distinguish between the algebra and geometry. So today we are going to start with the mathematics part 1, the first chapter. Now, as the name suggests, sets. Okay, this is the very first chapter, very first lecture and the introduction part. Okay, as the name sets suggest. So when you listen the word sets, what comes in your mind first? What comes in your mind? Set means what? A collection. Okay, all of you, all the opinion, your opinion will be different from person to person. Okay, everyone has a different point of view. They can think differently, so they have the different opinion. So here, when you heard the word set, suddenly the word comes the collection. Okay, collection. Now, what type of collection exactly? There are so many types of collection. Okay, so what type of collection? so that we are going to study what exactly the collection of things means, which type of collection. If I correlate this maths with the English, okay, if I correlate this maths with the English, in English you have studied nouns, proper noun, common noun, collective noun. Okay, so we will try to correlate our mathematics to other subject as well. Okay, so let's see now, what is a set? Actually, what is the concept of the sets? Okay, now if you will see on the screen, I have shown you some pictures. Okay, some pictures are there. First, if you see, it is a flower bouquet, then bunch of keys, then flock of birds, then pile of notebooks, then collection of numbers. Okay, now as I told you just now, okay, as I told you just now, that in English you have studied about nouns and under nouns, proper noun, common noun, collective noun, abstract noun, and so on. Okay, so if you will observe these pictures carefully, okay, students, if you will observe this picture carefully, you can see here some collective noun concepts are used. Okay, some collective noun concepts are used. That is, first, in the first picture, flower bouquet. Okay, bouquet. Okay, bouquet is a example of a collective noun. Okay, second, bunch of keys. Now keys are there, but when the keys are kept together, what is the collective noun here over use is the bunch. Okay, then in the third picture, birds, that is flock of birds. Your flock is a collective noun. Then pile of notebooks. Notebooks are kept, but what is the collection, collective noun used over here is a pile. Okay. And the last one is the collection of numbers. Whatever you can see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 till 12. Okay. Dot, dot, dot. It means it is an infinite. Still the numbers will be there. So it is what? Collection of nouns. Now all this bouquet, bunch, flock, pile, collection of numbers. Okay. Whatever the collective nouns used over here, whatever the collective noun used over here, that is, we can say that it is a set. Means your bouquet, for example, if I'll take a bouquet, flower bouquet, okay, it is collection of the flowers, collection of the flowers, and one particular name is given, one particular name is given, okay, that is bouquet. Then if you take the last example, that is a collection of numbers, collection of numbers. So here also numbers, I can say 1 2 3 4 5 6, okay, but if you will see, if you will say collection of numbers, it will be more precise. Okay, it will be more precise and it will be understandable. So whatever the words are used to describe a group or a collection of the objects, okay, here that is a bouquet, bunch, flock, pile, then collection of the numbers. Okay, so they are nothing but they are collection of some objects. Okay, they are collection of some objects, and that collection of that objects, it is called as what? Set. Okay, it is called as what? Set. Now more clearly, that this first example, flower bouquet, I can't give another name. That is a collection of the flowers. It doesn't look or it doesn't sound good. Okay, there is a specific name. There is a specific name for the collection. And that name we cannot change. We cannot change as per our wish. We cannot change as per our wish. Okay, so that is what it is called as what? Set. Means it is a fixed. It is fixed. It is a well-defined. More clearly, it is a well-defined. Okay. Now, if we'll take another example, pile of notebooks. Instead of pile of notebooks, if I'll say your set of 9th standard textbook. Set of 9th standard textbook. Now, in 9th standard, whatever textbook you have received from the school, there are different subjects, English, Hindi, Marathi, okay? They are one set, okay? And that we cannot change. That we cannot change, and it is a collection of a textbook which is well-defined. Which is what? Well-defined. So, that particular concept, it is called as what? Set, okay? Let's see more example. Okay. Now here again two pictures are there. Okay. Now in the first picture, if you will observe what it is, happy children in the village. And in the second picture, brilliant students in the class. Now, first I will explain this, then we will compare these two pictures with the previous one. Okay. Now, happy children in the village. Now, in village, suppose if I'll take example, okay, XYZ village. So, in that village, some students are happy because, of course, there is no physically school going on, okay. Then, some students, they are happy because they are, due to the online lecture, they are able to use the mobile. Some students, they are happy because some or the other reason. Okay? So, here the happy, this word happy, it differ from person to person. Now, I am happy because I am taking this first lecture of yours. I am happy to teach you. You are happy, some, those who are joining. Okay, those who are joining, some of them are happy because they love maths. Some are happy because whatever the reason. Means what? The word happy, it differs from person to person. It is not fixed. It is not fixed. Okay, let's go to the second example. Brilliant students in the class. Now here again, brilliant. Okay. Brilliant students in the class. Now, suppose if I take particular one class, 9th standard. Now, there are students who are very much brilliant in their studies. There are students who are brilliant in drawing. Some are brilliant in dancing. Some are brilliant in sports. Okay. So, this brilliant, it also differs from person to person. Okay. So, these two, happy children in the village and brilliant students in the class. I cannot say that this is a particular a set. Okay. This is particular a set. Why? Because here, whatever the collection of the objects that whatever they have used, happy children or the brilliant students, it is different from person to person, or it is not a well-defined. It is not a well-defined. So such examples we cannot call as a set. Okay. Now if I'll modify this example, okay, brilliant students in maths, okay, if I'll write brilliant students, let us say here only I will just brilliant students in maths, okay. Now here I am talking the brilliant students only in maths, okay. So here the specific word is used, maths. So I know that so many students are brilliant in maths, but in the original example, that is the brilliant students in the class, they have not specified. So this particular we cannot call it as a set, as well as happy children in the village. So to define a set, there should be a specific or well defined thing. Only then we can say that it is a set. Okay, I hope that you have now understood the difference between what is a set and what is not a set. Okay. Okay. Now, students, do you know that this particular set, it was first developed, this theory of sets was developed by a German mathematician, George Cantor. Okay. He was the first person to introduce or to develop the theory of sets. Okay. He was born in Russia on 3rd of March 1845, and he died on 6th of Jan 1918 in Germany. Okay. Now, this, it is a additional part that you should know, that who has developed the theory of sets. Okay. Now, this purposely I have taken the quote. Okay. This slide I have made purposely. Now, this is a famous quote by the mathematician, that is a George Cantor. What he was saying, that the essence of mathematics is in its freedom. Okay, the essence of mathematics is in its freedom. So as you know, that if you love maths, it will be easier for you. But if it is there in your mind that maths is difficult, then obvious it will be a difficult part for you. Okay. Okay, so till now we have just understood how to identify the set. Means if the collection of objects are given, then it is, we are able to identify which particular a set and which is not a set. Okay, now here is a definition of a set. If we can definitely and clearly decide the objects of a given collection, then that collection is called a set. Okay, as I told you that there is collection of objects everywhere, you can see a collection of objects. Okay, but if that collection of objects is a well-defined, clearly defined, okay, well-defined or clearly defined, then only we can call that collection as a set. Okay. Now, name of the sets. Now, whenever you want to write the name of a set, you are having all your names. Yes. So same way, if I want to define a set, if I want to write name of the set, then I will use only capital letters. Only what? Capital letters. And you know that in English alphabet, there are 26 alphabets. So any name you can use, A, B, C, D, X, Y, Z, okay? Any name you can use, but the condition is what? You have to use only and only capital letters. Okay? Further, we'll see that. Next, that is the member or element of the sex. Now, as I told you that you all are having your name. Okay? So, if I want to write the or if I want to give the name to a set, I will use the capital letter. Now, members or elements of the set. Now, what is that member? Member or element of the set. First of all, they are written or they are defined by a small letters. Means to write the name of the set, you will use capital letters. Whereas to write member of the element, member or the element of the set, you will use small letters. Okay. Now members means what? Now you, for example, if I will say that class 9, I'll say class 9, in your school, there must be different divisions, okay? One minute. Okay. In your school, there may be different division, A, B, C, D, okay? So if I'll say 9A, okay? Now this is what I have given the name of the set. Means I have used the capital letters, okay? Now in this 9A, there are different students, okay? So each student is the member of the 9A. Each student is the member or the element of the 9A. Same way, if I say that set A, okay, set A, and whatever the elements or whatever the members, they are represented by small letters. Okay, they are represented by small letters. Okay. So this is what, how you write the name of the set and how you write member or the elements of the set. Okay. These two things we are going to use frequently. So keep in mind, okay, that is name of the set and member or the element of the set. Okay. Now, as I told you that name of the set, it is given by capital letters, okay, and members of the set, it is denoted by small letters, okay. One more thing I want to tell you, that if I write set A, okay, set A is equal to, whenever you want to write any kind of set, you will use only and only curly brackets. Only and only curly brackets. No round brackets, no square brackets, okay? Only curly bracket you have to use. Yes? Now suppose, here I will give one example. Set A, this is the name of the set, okay? Now students, this I am going in detail because throughout the lesson, we are going to use this frequently. So again and again, we will not waste time in telling the name of the set, member of the set, element of the set, okay? So be attentive and pay attention. So So here, if I, let us write one example, that is a set A. Here I have used the capital letter A, okay, is equal to curly bracket, okay. Suppose A, B, C, okay. Now, if you see, I have open curly bracket and close curly bracket. That means whatever you are writing the members of the set, you have to write in open and close curly bracket. Okay. Now, here see, A is an element of set A. Okay. A is an element of set A. That means your this A, it is a member of the set A or no? Yes. This is the member of the set A. And this particular, now I am telling this, I am explaining this. A is a element or a member of set A. Now, if I want to write in a symbolic way, okay? You know that in maths, we are using the symbol. Like equal to, we don't write equal spelling, equal to. We just put a symbol. Plus, okay, minus. So, in maths also, here they have given in words, but how to represent in the symbolic way? That is, A is an element of A, or you can say that A belongs to A. Now, this particular sign, this is how you write, okay? This is the sign of belongs to. So, whenever the teacher in your school says belongs to, only in maths lecture students, okay? Belongs to. So no need of writing spelling of belongs to. The symbol itself understand that it is belongs to. Okay? Now, A belongs to set A. That means here it is understood that small a is an element or member of the set A. Capital A is the name of the set. Capital A is the name of the set. Okay. Now, if a particular element is not a member, if a particular element is not a member, then it is represented by, see how you write belongs to, like this. So when you put a stroke, that is it does not or it not belong to. Okay. Now here if I'll say A is equal to A, B, C. Now element D, does element D, it is there in this set? No. Okay. So how I will write? D does not belong to A. Okay. D does not belong to set A. If a particular element, it is there in the set, then how you will write that, for example, C. C is there in this set A or no? Yes. So C, it belongs to set A. Okay. So this is the difference between how you write belongs to and does not belongs to. Okay. I hope that this part is also clear. Okay. Because if you'll see, there are some questions in your exercise. And if you understand this, it will be really helpful to you to solve it by your own. Okay. Okay. So till now, we have seen the definition of the set. Okay, how to identify whether the given collection of object is a set or it is not a set. Then how to write the name of the set, then member of the set. Okay, also how to represent symbolic, whether it belongs to or it does not belong to a particular set. Okay. Now, Let us see the examples. Okay. Now let us see the examples. Now here, see the examples and decide whether it is a set or not. That means in exams also some examples will be given and you have to identify whether the given set is a set or it is not a set. Okay, so like that one example I have taken. Let us see. First one, days of a week. Days of a week. Then months in a year. Months in a year. Third one, brave children in the class. Fourth, first 10 counting numbers. First 10 counting numbers. Fifth one, strong forts of Maharashtra. And the sixth one, planets in our solar system. Now students, if you will see, there are six examples displayed on your screen. Okay, but from that six example, if you will observe the third one I have highlighted and the fifth one, okay, that is the brave children in the class and strong forts of Maharashtra. Now this particular collection, this is a collection, that is the brave children and strong forts. Okay, so this particular collection of object, it is not well defined or it is not clearly defined. Why it is not clearly defined? Because this particular term brave, okay, and strong, this particular term brave and strong, it will different from person to person. Okay, it will different from person to person. As I explained you in the previous slide, brilliant students in the class. So same way, brave children in the class. So children may show their bravery in not only in one field. Okay, they can show the bravery in different aspects. So this particular collection of object, it is not a set. Not a set. Okay. Now, strong forts of Maharashtra. Now strong. This particular term, it will be different from person to person. Okay. From person to person. So that's why it is also not a set. Now we have seen these two. Now let us see the other example. Now days of a week. Okay. Days of a week. Now this days of a week, they are fixed. We cannot change. As per our wish, can we change? No. Okay, so this collection of objects, that collection of days, that is a week, it is fixed, it is well defined, clearly defined. Okay, so it will be a set. Next, months in a year. You know that in a year, how many months are there? 12. We can't say that this year, 2021, there will be 15 months. Next year, it will be 12 months. No, they are not. And they are fixed. They are well defined. We cannot change them. Okay. So this particular, again, it will be a set. Okay. Then, first 10 counting numbers. Now here they have clearly mentioned. See, again and again, I am just focusing on the word clearly and well defined. Okay, here they have clearly mentioned first 10 counting numbers, first 10. Okay, this is clearly mentioned. Now if I'll say counting numbers means what? It will be infinite. But here first 10 means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, only first 10. So that is what a well-defined collection of numbers. So again, this will be a set. Okay. Then, planets in our solar system. All of you know how many planets are there, the names of the planet. Yes. So that particular we cannot change. They are fixed. They are what? Fixed. So that collection of the planets, okay, it will be a set. It will be a set. So in short, till now we have seen well-defined, clearly, more precisely, okay. So all this, in short, what is a set? It is a collection of the objects. But it should be a well-defined, means what? It should be a fixed, that we cannot change. That particular, it is called as what? Set. So this six, with the help of this six example, I think it is more clear now. Okay, let's move to the next. Set of numbers. Now here, this you have studied from your lower class. Okay. Which are the sets of number? First one, natural number. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever we are saying, naturally, starting from 1. And till now, we don't know till date. Okay. We don't know the last number. So that is what the infinite. So natural numbers are infinite. And natural numbers, as I told you, that if I want to write a set, I will use the capital letters. Now here, natural number, they are fixed. Okay, we cannot change them. So that is a set. That particular, it is a set. At the same time, set of all natural numbers, they are denoted by only letter N. Okay, only letter N. Okay, this is fixed. So this particular slide I have kept because this words or this, sorry, this letters you are going to use for this particular sets only. Okay. Now, if I want to write set of natural numbers from 1 to first 10 natural numbers, if I want to write first 10 natural numbers, then I will use the set N or whatever the element of the natural number, they will belongs to only capital letter N. Okay. Next is a whole number. Whole number, all of you know that it starts from 0. 0, 1, 2, 3, so on. Okay. And whole number, again, it is denoted by letter W. You cannot use to denote the set of whole numbers by any other letter. Okay. So you have to use only letter W to denote set of whole numbers. Then I, capital I, that is a set of integers. Integers means what, students? A number line. Now when you think of the number line, suddenly in your mind what comes? 0, positive, negative. Okay. So here also, 0, positive and negative numbers, they are what? Set of integers. and they are represented by capital letter I. Okay, then Q, that is set of rational numbers. Set of rational numbers. Now here, this I want to explain it more. Rational number, they are nothing but in the form P upon Q. Okay, they are in the form P upon Q. For example, first I will Q is equal to P upon Q, okay, curly bracket, such that P comma Q, it belongs to integer and Q is not equal to zero. This is the definition of rational number. That is, rational number, they are always in the form P upon Q. That means any fraction, it is a rational number. Example, 2 upon 7. That is a numerator and denominator. Any type of fraction, it is a rational number. Okay. Then, R is a set of real numbers. Real numbers. In real numbers, there are natural, whole, integers, and rational numbers. Means real number, it is a big set, okay? And under that, all comes. That is natural number, whole number, integers, rational, all comes under real numbers. And it is denoted by letter R, okay? It is denoted by letter R. So these are set of numbers. And this also you have to keep in mind, because we are going to use this frequently in this particular lesson. Okay. And remember the letter, whatever we are using for natural number, whole number, integers, rational numbers, and real numbers. Okay. Now, write the following symbolic statement in words. It is there in your practice set 1.1, okay, on page number 3. Now, as I told you before, that in maths, you should know the symbols. So here also, we should know how to express words in symbol and symbol in words. Okay, so what is the question? That write the following symbolic statement in words. First one, 4 upon 3. 4 upon 3 belongs to Q. Okay, now as I told you just now, set of numbers, Q is nothing but it is a rational number. Okay, and you can see that 4 upon 3, it is a fraction. Okay, so this is given in symbol, you have to write in words. That is, 4 upon 3 is an element of the set Q. Now, 4 upon 3 belongs to means what? That particular element, it is the set. So this 4 upon 3 is an element of set Q. Okay. Now, here if you write instead of Q, if you write rational number, then also it will do. Okay. So 4 upon 3, this symbol belongs to, means what? It is an element of the set Q. Okay. It is an element of the set Q. Now, next, minus 2, you can see the symbol that is belongs to and one stroke. That means what? Does not belong. Means it is not an element. Okay. So minus 2 does not belongs to n. Now your n means what? Natural numbers. N means what? Natural numbers. You know that minus 2 is nothing but it is an integer. Okay, it is an integer. Yes or no? Just now we have seen in sets of number, minus 2 is an integer. So we cannot say that minus 2 is an element of natural number. Okay, so how you will write in words? Minus 2 is not an element of the set N. Okay. Next, P is equal to, I will just explain this. P is equal to curly bracket P. Okay. And here you can see how they have written P is equal to curly bracket. As I told you that you have to use only curly bracket and small p. Okay. Why? Because this is an element of the set P. And here one line, this line. Okay. This is nothing but such that. Okay. This line, it is termed as such that, or it is read as such that. So P is equal to curly bracket P such that P is an odd number. Is an odd number, curly bracket close. Okay. Now here you will say that teacher, it is already given in words. And what or how to write in words? Okay. So here it is given in words, but it is given in the form of a set. Okay. And we have to precisely write in words or in a statement form. So how we will write set P? Okay. This is the name of the set. That is a set P is a set. This particular, it is a set of all P's. That means now this small p, what I said, it is an element or it is a member. Okay. Small letter we normally use for denoting the member or the element of that particular set. Okay. So of all p's such that p is an odd number. So here simply you have to write in words that set P is a set. Set P, it is a set of all P's, of all P's such that P is what? An odd number. Okay. Only thing is that here, that symbol of the such that you have to remember, a line that is the symbol of such that. Okay. So I think that this three examples, that means how you can write in a symbolic as well as in the words. Okay. Now, see it. This symbol, it is what it belongs to. As I told you, this symbol means what belongs to. Okay. So when you read, you will read that 4 upon 3 belongs to Q. Okay. 4 upon 3 belongs to Q. But when you write, how you will write that 4 upon 3 is an element of the set. Okay. Is an element of the set. So this is the difference. Okay. See here, same example I have taken. Okay. Let us. Just now I have explained this example only. Set P, curly bracket P, such that P is an odd number. So here, how you will write it? In words, in a statement form. Okay. Now another example, that is a set Q. Q equals to curly bracket A E I O U. Okay. A E I O U. Now here simple they have mentioned. Okay. Now here this is A E I O U. It is what? Vowels. They are what? Vowels in English alphabet. So here you can write it in a statement form. How you will write it? That set Q. Here I have not taken the set Q as a rational number. Here I have, see, I have written A E I O U. Means that means I have already mentioned. Okay. So set Q is a set of all vowels in English alphabet. Okay. Set Q is a set of all vowels in English alphabet. Here, if you see the difference, it is given in words. Okay. This particular thing, that is methods of writing, that is a listing method, rule method, we will study in the next class in detail. That time it will be more clear. But now here, if you'll see, in the bracket, they have given in words that P, such that P is an odd number. It is given already in a word. Okay. But our duty is to more clear this concept, that is P, such that P. Okay. We have to clear it more precisely. But here, if you'll see, it is given, it is not given in words, or it is not given in a statement form. That is only they have given A, E, I, O, U. A, E, I, O, U. This is what all of you know. It is a vowels, set of vowels in English alphabet. Okay. So this is the difference. Both are sets. Both are written in the curly bracket. But there is difference in writing the sets. Now next, we'll, I have from your practice set 1.1, I think only question number 2, it is based on whatever we have done today, okay? And this is additional, and the previous one that I have taken, that was the additional example, okay? Now here, solve the following. That means they have given the question. First, what is the question? That which of the following collections is a set? Which of the following collection is a set? Colors of the rainbow, tall trees in the school campus, which people in the village, and fourth one is what? Easy examples in the book. Okay, here 4 sets I have given you. Now here you have to identify which of this following it is a set. Okay, which of the following it is a set. Now, if you will see carefully, the first example, that is colors of the rainbow, okay? I think someone mic is on. Please mute it. Okay. Thank you. Now, colors of the rainbow. Tall trees in the school campus, rich people in the village, easy examples in the book. Now, one by one we'll see. Colors of the rainbow. Now, all of you know that in a rainbow, there are 7 colors, and of course, they are fixed. They are well defined. We cannot change. Okay? Let's go to the next example. Tall trees in the school campus. Now, tall trees. Now, if I send four students, okay, there will be variation in their answers to find which are the tall trees in the school campus, because this concept, that is the tall tree, again, it will differ from person to person. Okay, next example, that is rich people in the village. So, people, rich people in the village. So, here also this rich people, the point of view, how you will define the richness, okay, in terms of money, in terms of kindness, in terms of behavior, okay. So, that particular term, it is relative and it will be differ from person to person, okay. Then fourth example, that is easy examples in the book. Now, easy examples in the book. Now, there are examples. So, some students, they might find few example easy. Then some other student, they might find the other example easy. That means this easy example, it will be again different. It will be differ from student to student. Okay. I cannot say that all the examples are easy for everyone. All examples are easy for everyone. Now, just now what we have learned, what is the set? How to define a set? How to write a set? How to write the member of the set? How to write symbolically and in words? So, it will be easier for some students. It will be easy. It will not be easier for other students. Okay, so it is differing from person to person, from student to student. So, easy example in the book. Okay, so out of this four collection of a set, if you see the first one, that is the color of the rainbow, which is fixed one, which is well defined, okay, and it is same for everyone. That means I will say that there are seven colors in rainbow. And violet, indigo, green, blue, okay. Then if I ask which are the colors in the rainbow and how many colors are, your answer will also be the same. Okay. So this particular option A will be the correct answer. That is, it is a collection of set. It is a collection of set. Now if I say tall trees, if I say that for me this is a tall, that was not so tall, that was a small. But if I'll ask two more people, from their point of view, the answers may be different. Okay. So, in this three example, whatever the concepts is there, whatever the terms are there, they are different from person to person. Person to person. And so, we cannot call that particular as a set. Okay. So, in generally, or in short, if you want to remember what or how to identify whether it is a collection of set or not, then it should be a fixed. Like in maths, we know that there are infinite and finite. Countable means what? Finite. It is fixed. We cannot change them. We cannot change them. Okay? Like colors of the rainbow, vowels, then planets in our solar system, days of the week. We cannot change them. We cannot change them. They are fixed forever. So such type of collection of objects, they are called as what? Sets. They are called as what? Sets. Okay. So today what we have done, that is the what is the definition of the set? And of course, this beautiful theory who developed, that is the German mathematician, George Cantor, okay? He was the first person to develop that theory of the sets. And he has really gave his valuable contribution in this theory of the sets, okay? If you are more interested, you can go to the Google and search by his name. You can find out which books or what contribution he has done in this. Okay, then we have seen how to write the name of the element, member of the element, how to write in words. Okay, so means what? Basically, today we have seen only the basic things. Whatever, what are there in the sex? What are there in the sex? Okay, and I hope that you have understood this. Okay. What we have done today. So tomorrow we'll see the further and the actual part, further and the actual part of the sex. Okay, that